If you ever wear a surgical face mask for more than an hour at a time, or felt the itchy fabric brush past your nose, you will know how stuffy or itchy masks can be. This is a mask hack to make surgical masks more comfortable and easier to breathe in. This is a regular mask, and this is the modified mask. The modified mask stays popped open and never sticks to your face, making it more comfortable and easier to breathe in. This also makes it easier to talk in, as it gives your mouth space to move as well. This trick is based on respirator shapes. You will notice all disposable respirators have a big domed space for breathing that always stays popped outwards, while masks can end up collapsing and sticking to your face. You'll need a transparent, rigid, and flat plastic. I got mine from a salad container. Scissors to cut the plastic into shape. Tape, paper or cloth tape works best. Ruler, flexible rulers and tape rulers work best. Permanent marker, able to write on plastic. Measure your mask. To do this, get a ruler. I suggest flexible tape rulers. And a permanent marker. Go to the inside of your mask. This is the side with a lighter color. Mark the middle point at the bottom of the mask inside, at the chin area. Mark a second middle point right at the nose wire. Use the two dots to find the mask lanes. A flexible tape ruler makes this slightly easier than a rigid ruler. The plastic will go across the mask, starting below the nose wire. Therefore, the plastic is 1 inch wide and slightly shorter than the mask length. If the plastic sticks out of the mask when you tape it, you can cut it shorter. Get a piece of transparent, rigid, and flat plastic. The type in produce containers. Type 1 plastic like this shown here works quite well. Draw the template on the plastic before you cut it out. Permanent markers can draw on plastic. Cut the plastic strip out, following the marker lines to make it easier. Tape the plastic onto the mask, making sure it curves outward and pushes the mask wide open. Push the plastic outwards as much as you can. If the plastic makes an S shape, loosen slightly until right before it happens. You want it to curve outwards, but if you press on it too much, it will bend inwards again, and that's not what you want. Get a hole puncher if you can, and punch holes along the center of the plastic strip. This is optional. The holes will make breathing only slightly easier, and it is not as important. Leave around 1 inch at the bottom of the plastic strip without any hole punches, because this will be in contact with your chin, and holes will be still irritating even if it is on the smooth side. You want to make sure to punch holes on the same side of the mask. Hole punches will make one side of the hole rough, and the other side of the hole smooth. This way, one entire side of the plastic strip will be smooth and comfortable when you wear the mask. This is how you want to attach a plastic strip. Tape the plastic strip on the center of the mask, right below the nose wire. Paper and cloth tape is better because they don't irritate the skin if they rub your chin while you wear the mask. If you use the hole puncher, check for the smooth side of the mask. You want this to be the part that touches your skin because this side will be less irritating than the rough side. Make sure it faces inwards towards your skin before taping it to the mask. If this trick helps you, please share the video, like, and make extra plastic strips for your friends and family. Remember, the plastic strip is reusable. Just take it off the old mask, wash it, dry it, and then tape it to a new mask. Here's a quick items list at the end of the video, so you can pause and read through it a little easier.